Ronnie Jurgens here. You ever wanted to make fast cash flipping old lawnmowers? Then you need to come to my workshop. I'll show you how to make tons of money buying and selling these old lawnmowers. You don't even need any mechanical skills. All you need is that $5,000 initial investment. And make them checks out to me, and I'll show you exactly how easy it is. Hey, I made well over $1 million last year buying and selling old mowers just like this. Here are some real-life testimonials from some real-life people. It's definitely not me dressed up as a couple of other different people. I used Ronnie's tips, and I made a boatload of money. I sank the boat. Thanks, Ronnie. You're the bestest. I'm a woman, and even I can do it. It was the best $5,000 I ever spent. Thanks, Ronnie. You're the best. I want to share my secrets with you, because I don't even know what to do with all this money. Hey, kid.
What?
You want some?
Yeah.
It's so easy. Anybody with $5,000 laying around can do it. The outdoor power equipment industry is a $50 billion a year industry. Don't you want a piece of that? I know I do, and I'm gonna show you how to go out and get it. The workshop is this weekend, so make sure you bring the $5,000 with you, and you'll be on your way to millions. Cash is preferred, but I'll take a check, as long as you make it out to me, Ronnie Jagenstein. So call this number here at the bottom of the screen, and I'll tell you when and where to meet me. Oh yeah! Get yourself a piece of that!
Pterodactyl here, and today's how-to video is going to be on how to fix this cracked block on this Kohler Courage engine. Want to see? See, somebody tried fixing it once already, and they had it welded up, but it didn't hold, and the reason it doesn't hold is these bolts came loose again. That's why it breaks in the first place. This one came loose. This one broke off. This one's loose. See, finger tight. And this one backed itself out so far, the flywheel was rubbing on it. And when that happens, it cracks the block. Watch, I'm gonna crank it over. Now, I could tighten these bolts all up and that thing won't move again, but it's just gonna work itself loose. Now, I've seen a bunch of videos on YouTube where guys will take a plate of steel and put it over that with some JB weld and drill and tap it and bolt that plate on there to hold it together. Well, that's a good repair. I like that repair. But in the case of this one, the crack is right here, along here. And there's no way I can put a plate of steel on there. And then what if you don't have a plate of steel or a drill and a tap to tap it? So you know what? Old Pterodactyl came up with a better idea. It's hillbilly, but you know I am a hillbilly. And what I did is I modicated a 3-inch C-clamp. See, I started with this 3-inch C-clamp and then I modicated it to this. I had to grind the head of it here a little bit, and I had to grind a notch in it, and then I cut some of this off and ground a point on there, and look, fits in there real nice. And then that point will actually dig a little point into the block there, and that'll help hold it. Plus it shortens this up, so you ain't got this big long threaded piece sticking out, and you can tighten that down. Not real tight, but tight enough to hold the block together, and then tighten up your bolts again. Now, I would suggest loctiting these when you go to put it back together. Now, in the case of this one, I'm going to have to pull this cover and get that broken bolt out of there. And I also see a blue part of the gasket out. So, see, that fits in there real nice. And then also, the cover, which is over here now, the cover will fit back on. See? And it's really not that noticeable, and you can close the hood. And then you don't need a bunch of tools and stuff to make this repair. But I also have to go back and grind off all this weld and seal it up. You can use JB Weld, you could use silicone, but I'm gonna use what we endorse, and that's that epoxy putty that you can get off of our website, which you'll see at the end of this video. I'm gonna patch that with that to keep that from leaking. All right, I gotta fix this because somebody welded all on there, so I gotta grind that out, and I'm gonna use this ball carbide tip in my angle grinder. You might have to use something else, but. All right, now we're ready for the epoxy putty. I really like this stuff, and you can buy this from our website. You'll see the link at the end of the video. Got my trusty knife. I'm gonna cut off a good slab of this. Get the plastic from around it. Just knead it together. I wear gloves. You do what you want. You want to wear gloves? Go ahead. You don't want to wear gloves? Mix it with your naked fingers. I don't care. I suggest gloves. This stuff sets up pretty fast too. There's instructions in there. Make sure you read them. Hello. You can roll it into a little rope to help you push it in there. Now I got this pretty much, you know, you kind of want it so it's got some tooth to it. So I kind of scratched it up real good so it'll have some bite, some tooth. And then this crack went all the way up underneath. So I'm going to put some under there too. And as it starts to set up, you can, you know, because it kind of sticks to the glove a little bit, you can let it set up a little and then smoosh it around some more. And then we'll put my clamp back on. Okay, the putty's set up. I got the clamp back on. It's all nice and tight. Got to put the cover back on. Put the four bolts in, dipstick back in. And that's all there is to my hillbilly repair on that there cracked block on this Kohler Courage. And there's your dinner. Ha ha, there's your dinner. Ha ha, fixing that crack.
Yeah, is this Ronnie? Yeah, I want to learn how to flip lawnmowers and make all that cash. When and where can I meet you? Oh, okay, yeah, that sounds good. Yeah, I got the $5,000. Unmarked bills, just like you asked. All right, I'll see you then. All right, bye.
Oh, all right, Pa, we got him. We got a mate behind the plaza at 2 p.m. for his workshop.
That's good. Now we could trap that scumbag and we can get our money back.
Yeah.
I don't see him anywhere. He must not be here yet.
Yeah, you know what? I got a good idea. I think I'll hide back here and wait for that scumbag.
All right, sounds good.
All right.
Oh, hey, guy. Over here. Did you bring the cash with you?
Yeah, sure did. Got it right here.
All right, as soon as I get the transaction, then we can begin with the workshop.
Jigs up, Randy!
What?
I think you owe me some money for them lawnmowers you stole out of my yard.
What? I didn't steal no lawnmowers.
All right,
I got some money here. All right, there you go.
$2? I know you got more than that, you scumbag.
All right, I think I got another $5 somewhere.
I know you got more than $5 on you.
Quick twist to my arm and let me stand up. Hey, I'll get you the rest of your money.
All right.
Taking a swing at me, huh? Well, let's see if you got a backbone, you spineless weasel. I hope you learned your lesson this time, Ronnie, but somehow I think you haven't.
Oh, no, I learned my lesson. I'm never going to scam again.
Yeah, this is what I'm looking for.
Oh, no. No.
All right, Junior, let's get back to the shop. I got some Christmas parts I got to order now that I got some of my money back.
All right, Paul, let's go.
Ronnie? I had
a 3 o'clock appointment. We're gonna flip a llama.
Hey, yeah, I'm the guy. Just give me a second to straighten my spine back out, and I'll be right with you. So, you got the cash?
$5,000 unmarked bills, just like you asked. Yeah, I got it.
Oh, this really hurts. Oh, yeah.